SnowTrax is sponsored by Ski-Doo. Better rides, better riders. Yamaha. Snowmobiles built for the real world. That's the Yamaha Advantage. And by FXR Racing. World-class outerwear.
Everyone wonders, speculates, and argues which 800cc crossover sled is the best. Which one's the fastest, which one handles best on the trail, which one's the best off-trail. The areas of debate almost seem endless. So today, we're gonna take the industry's three hottest 800 crossovers and rip into their every detail. We'll hold nothing back, and at the end of this shootout, we'll tell you which one we think will provide the best overall riding experience for the largest number of riders. Instead of simply commenting on how each sled performs in a specific area, I'm going to award between 1 and 3 points for each area of comparison. Then I'm going to combine those total points with an overall experience score that's worth twice as much out of 6 total points to find out who the winner is. Hopefully this will limit any reservations you might have about brand loyalty or test rider bias. The categories for comparison are going to be power and performance, ride and handling, style and comfort, extras and value, and finally, the overall experience. A perfect score would be 18 points. The lowest possible score a sled could get would be only 6. Over the past few seasons, Ski-Doo has been embroiled in the most heated battle in history in the 800cc class. And many would argue, based strictly on motor performance and economy, they're winning. The heart and soul of the 800 Renegade is its direct-injected twin-cylinder E-Tech mill. It puts out 164 claimed horsepower and feels more than strong enough all through its power band. But more than just powerful, the 800 E-Tech is smooth as silk, starts and idles perfectly no matter the conditions, sips fuel, is easy on oil, and has proven to be quite reliable. All things considered, we give the 800 Renegade with its E-Tech power plant a solid 3 out of 3 points in the power and performance category. This season, Ski-Doo brought us the absolutely incredible R-Motion skid in the Renegade 137-inch length. Our X package included the rapid adjust setup on the running boards, and there's absolutely no question, this skid is downright incredible. Bumps literally disappear. From small chatter to big hits, I'm constantly amazed at how this skid eats bumps for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and then a few more for dessert. In the ride department, this thing deserves a 3, big time. But this category also includes handling. And we've said this before, and it's no more or less true today. The RevXS front end is extremely precise and handles flatter than a chipmunk on the highway. But this precision and flat cornering come at the expense of straight line stability. In fewer words, it feels nervous. The extra length of the 137 skid helps, but the nervous feeling is still present. Combine its near perfect ride quality with its precise but nervous feeling handling traits, and the RevXS Renegade 800 still gets 3 points. It's just not as strong a 3 points as it was before. The latest rendition of the RevXS is, in our opinion, a sweet looking sled with clean and smooth lines and stylish angles. It's got a sweet body, but Ski-Doo seems to have forgot about the makeup on this beauty. Where's the graphics? Whether or not a sled is comfortable is a very personal thing. What's comfortable for one may feel awkward to another. Most of our test riders agree that the RevXS is comfortable enough, but not the most comfortable sled in this competition. So, in the comfort and style category, the RevXS gets 2 out of 3 points. The list of extras included as standard equipment on the X package Renegade is the longest in its class. Decent storage above the gauge pod and in the back of the seat, highly functional remote adjusters on the tunnel, all the electronic gadgets you'd need or want, and a price that's identical to the Arctic Cat. While it does have more gadgets and storage than any other sled in this competition, it also costs more than the Polaris, meaning the Renegade 800 is a good deal on a great sled, but not a standout in the extras and value category, earning 2 points of a possible 3. This gives it a total of 10 out of possible 12 points in the competition. Arctic Cat crossover sleds have suffered through a number of identity crises in the past, but the 2013 XF 800 Snow Pro Limited has become a standout sled in this season's fleet. This is due in large part to its absolutely sick 800 EFI mil. We don't like that it smokes so much, we don't like that it loads up when it's left to idle, and we don't like how hard it is on oil, but man, is this thing fast. Its claimed 160 plus horsepower is more than believable, and every single test rider who climbed off it said the same thing. Man, does this thing go! But here's the bottom line. Being a strong performer isn't enough. Big horsepower wouldn't be enough to win this category. Luckily, Arctic's 800 EFI mil also gets the second best fuel mileage of the three. In this category, the XF800 gets 2 of 3 points. Ride and handling is the single biggest area of improvement on this season's Arctic Cat models. Handling is good, with predictable turn-in and just a hint of understeer mid-corner, and the ride is decent. We're not big fans of the 144-inch mountain-style skid or its Fox air shocks. We think a version of the slide-action skid would make a lot more sense in this model. Ride and handling combined for pleasant trail manners and a stronger-than-average bias toward off-trail riding. When you put this sled beside its competition, it still has trouble competing at the front of the pack and earns one more point. I'm just gonna come right out and say it. In my opinion, this is the best looking snowmobile on the planet, without the giant windshield, of course. And this is an opinion shared by even some of the most loyal owners of other brands. Arctic hit the style nail so square on the head, you could cut yourself on its edges. Furthermore, this sled has a very nice ergonomic layout, making it very comfortable to sit on. People who ride it often come away commenting on how it just seems to fit and, unlike its predecessors, doesn't feel bulky at all. All things considered, 2 to 3 points are well earned in this area. The XF800 doesn't come with a lot of stuff. It's got a tunnel bag behind the seat, a nice set of handguards, and a decent gauge package, but there's really not a lot of extras to speak of. It also ties with the Skidoo for the most expensive sled in this competition. This doesn't necessarily make it a bad value. You're getting class-leading horsepower and enough style to impress even the most angry female environmentalist. So we think in this area, the Skidoo and the Cat are on par, and 2 to 3 points is fair. With everything tallied up, the Arctic Cat XF 800 Limited earns a total of 7 points. But keep in mind, we're saving the overall experience points for the very end, and they could have a huge effect on the outcome of this competition. Polaris has taken a laser-guided approach to their crossover lineup in the past two seasons. The Switchback Pro-R 800 is designed to be the ultimate long-track, high-traction trail sled, and most of our crew is not arguing with that. The 800 Clean Fire is better than it's ever been. It's got bellowing torque all through its power band, and it literally sips oil, almost to the point you'll be worried it's not using enough. It's not as good on fuel as the E-Tech, and it doesn't run as clean. But if you look at the total cost to run this sled versus its biggest economic competition, the E-Tech, mile for mile, they are nearly identical. In this category, we feel the Polaris semi-direct injected 800 deserves 2 of 3 points. If there's two things this sled does extremely well, it's ride and handle. Its ProRide rear end with 136-inch extended rails is almost on par with Skidoo's 137 version of their R-Motion skid. In fact, it might almost be too close to call. But in terms of handling, the Switchback wins more hearts than any other sled in our fleet. Nearly every person who rides it comes away saying it handles great. More people say they prefer the Rev, but still like the Switchback, than people who say they prefer the Switchback, but still like the Rev. In this area, the Switchback gets all 100% of its perfect 3-point score. In the style department, Polaris is doing some things extremely well and could improve on some things also. Their graphics packages are without a doubt the most stylish in the industry and complement the somewhat strange lines of the ProRide bodywork perfectly. But the Switchback does have a look that can take some time to get used to. It grows on most, but some never really get it. On the other hand, this sled is probably one of the most comfortable ever made. Everyone who sits on it agrees, ergonomically, it's as close to perfect as any sled has ever been. Take both of these into consideration and you end up with a realistic 2 out of 3 possible points for style and comfort. Like the Arctic Cat, the Switchback Pro-R doesn't come with a lot of extras included from the factory. If you get the early season LE model like this one, you get all kinds of goodies, but the in-season Pro-R comes with only the basics. A small storage pouch, a nice gauge package, and a pick-your-own windshield option doesn't really make much of a list. But this sled retails for $800 less than its competition. It comes with a full set of super high-end and fully adjustable Walker Evan shocks as well. When you take into consideration what you get for what you're going to pay, the Pro R gets a 3 of 3, which gives it a total score of 10 and makes it tied with the Renegade. Experience is something that isn't necessarily linked to the physical attributes of one sled versus another. And now that we have the total scores for each sled, we need to add in the overall experience scores to see which one will come out on top. Keep in mind, the overall experience scores are worth twice as much as all the other categories. Arctic XF 800LE received 4 out of 6 points for overall experience. Testers concluded that its motor and cool looks accounted for a lot of that score, but the below average ride from its 144-inch mountain-style skid frame took away from the overall experience on a long day's ride. This resulted in a total score of 11 for the Arctic Cat and landed it in third place. Now here's where things start to get a little bit sticky. Both the Switchback and the Renegade earned a total of 10 points, which means the winner is going to be determined by the overall experience points score. Believe it or not, they tied there too. It seems that pretty much every rider really likes both and gave them 6 points. So here's my final verdict. These two sleds have an equal number of high and low points in every category. Riders appear polarized between the two in terms of ride, handling, and ergonomic comfort. Which means you need to determine for yourself which one's handling characteristics and ergonomic layout suit you best. It's simply not possible to be any more decisive than this. So I'm just going to end this shootout by pointing out both the Polaris Switchback 800 and Ski-Doo Renegade 800 earned a total of 16 points. The math says they both win. You know what? I tend to agree.
Today on Test Ride, we're covering a sled I am genuinely excited about, Ski-Doo's Renegade X 800. I'm excited about the fact that it has an 800 E-Tech mill, and it's pretty cool that it's got the all-new XS bodywork. But here's where my enthusiasm is really coming from. This sled has been knighted by the SnowTrax and SuperTrax test riders as the best riding snowmobile in the business. That's a big statement to open a test ride with, isn't it? If we were tentative about calling the Rennie 800 the best riding sled in the biz, we probably would have left that comment until the last 30 seconds or so of this feature. Instead, we're going to go right to the core of our rationale for this bold and, quite frankly, indisputable proclamation. We've made this statement based on this reality. The 137-inch R-Motion rear skid is the bomb, the pinnacle, the highest form of the snowmobile species when it comes to ride quality on anything from sucker bumps to craters to jigglers. It's true, when the 120-inch R-Motion landed 2 seasons ago, it was impressive. However, the 137 R-Motion is a paradigm shifter. The Renegade 137 gobbles up trail junk like the Crocs on swamp people consume dogs. It might be worth talking about bottomless suspension in the context of it being too mushy or raising ride height and causing CG-induced handling quirks. Honestly, this isn't part of the discussion. The R-Motion 137 resides in its longer tunnel, displaying the same precise and polite manners as the 120-incher does. The long-stroking R-Motion 137 maintains ride height at SC5 levels, but increases travel by collapsing deeper than any production skid into the Renegade's tunnel. The result? Zero zip, not a compromise to handling. Let's talk about adjustability. If R-Motion just delivered the best ride in the business, but was difficult or temperamental to set up, our critical test riders would not be so taken with it. That is simply not the case. These tunnel-mounted adjusters make fiddling with rear arm compression dampening and rear torsion spring preload so easy, it's stupid. Before we move on to other aspects of the Renegade 800, there's one more thing we need to disclose about the Renegade's lofty command of the best ride in the business status. For sure, its R-Motion loves being in a 137 Renegade. It's undeniable all 120 or 121-inch rear suspensions ride better when stretched to 136 or 137-inch status. We saw this unequivocally with the Polaris Pro Ride Switchback 136. So when it comes to R-Motion, the same rules apply. The mogul bridging effect of the longer 137-inch rails have taken this sled to a level of ride quality never experienced in the snowmo industry. So what engine is worthy of powering a snowmobile suspension this imposing? Clearly, Ski-Doo owns the most advanced two-stroke technology in the business. Therefore, the Renegade gets Rotax 800cc twin with their fuel-miserly, EPA-clean E-Tech direct injection system. The 800 E-Tech is the smoothest running, easiest starting, most fuel-efficient, coolest sounding, 163-horsepower two-stroke twin on planet Earth. Yes, this year Arctic Cat's 800 is faster, and Polaris 800 is better on oil. However, when the entire package comes together, it's very difficult not to come to this conclusion. This is the most impressive 800 two-stroke mill in the industry. So maybe you Ski-Doo haters are gagging at my over-the-top pronouncements on this 800 E-Tech Renegade. Well, here's something you'll enjoy. We're not nearly as excited about this sled's nervous on-center handling and heavy steering effort. There are other sleds in this segment which do these two things better. We do approve wholeheartedly of the all-new XS bodywork on the Renegade X 800. The new skin displays tighter fit and finish, and just as importantly, improved function in at least three areas. First, the new body profile is warmer, even with a low windshield. Second, there's finally credible storage in a dry, easy-to-access spot behind the windshield. And thirdly, this new skin improves belt and clutch cooling by over 30%, channeling more air through improved clutch ducting and a new belt guard. So how does this Renegade X perform off-trail? In a word, amazing, and here's why. Don't get upset at me when I say this every year, but light is right, and this 800 Renegade is a feather. With a 125 under it, it's impressive. With a 175 out back, it can dig a trench deep enough to lay phone cable. When it's all said and done, the Renegade X 800 E-Tech is a crossover model targeted more at trail riding and occasional off-trail forays than backcountry free riding. This version of the Renegade will deliver trail sensations completely familiar to 120 and 121-inch riders, demanding zero compromise from its pilot. The sled handles, turns in, and exits corners with nary a hint of its wearing a 137-inch shoe. What's even better is its amazing ride quality on any trail in your dreams or in your nightmares. I told you at the beginning of this test ride segment that we're convinced the Renegade 800 E-Tech with R-Motion is the bomb. It convinced us with its performance, handling, fuel efficiency, and incredible ride quality that it is at or near the very top of the 800 crossover segment. So my question for you is this: are you convinced it's the bomb?
SnowTrax has been sponsored by Polaris, Terrain Domination, Arctic Cat, Share Our Passion, Yamaha. Snowmobiles built for the real world. That's the Yamaha Advantage. And by Go Ride Ontario. There's no place like this.